On exercise three, we are to configure automatic naming, configure administrator approval. We've already done that earlier on when we did the installation, but I will show you how to do that if, for example, you were asked to do it on a WDS server that has not already been configured with that on the when it was being set up. Then we're going to configure Active Directory permission, which is exactly where we specify that the administrator needs to what? Approve the system. Okay, so to configure the naming strategy, can we go to the property of the server, which is server1.pcu.local? Can we right click on the server and can we go to the property? Can we go to the property? Just a minute. Okay, so I right click now, I'll go to properties. Now that's the property of the server system. Now we need to set up automatic naming. So that, you know what automatic naming means? It means that every time we install the server system or any computer system using that image or whatever image we have there, what will happen if the computer is going to be computer 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, or lab 1, PC 2, lab 3, PC 4. So as you keep installing the computer, each of those computers will bear the same name. So it will be in an alphabetical what? Order. Meaning, if you've given number 1, it will give number 1 twice. It will give 01, 02, 03, 04, 05, 06. Are we together? Especially in a company like, let's say, for example, municipality. Let's say municipality's computer name are maybe MUW01 or 02, 03, 04. So as they deploy those computers with that image, it's going to automatically do the naming of the computer system. So you don't need to go in manually to rename the computer from the beginning. Yeah, but I hope this time it works. Last year, I actually have an issue doing that naming. Okay, can we look for the Active Directory Domain Services tab? You see it there, right? Click on it. Now, the format there, it's, you can see the format there. Is that not correct? Excuse me. Can you see the format there? Now, it's going to automatically use the username as the computer name. Just like default, whenever you install Windows, the username automatically becomes the computer name. Are we following? So, in this case, we're going to type the branch dash SROV dollar sign, then we're going to put 03 because this server is going to be server 3. So let's go there and type it. Yeah, just type it after the username branch.
Leave it
61 first. Branch dash SVR dash 0. Okay, we don't put 03. We just put, put 03. Now remember, we asked that this computer should be added to the research OU.
Yes.
So you notice that it says, on the computer location, the same as the WDS server or the same as the user performing the installation or same organizational unit as the user performing the installation or the following location. So we click the following location. We click on browse. Of course, we go to our PCE.local domain. We expand it. Then we look for a research OU. Is that a research OU? So we click on the research OU, we select. So that will be the location the computer is going to be installed in. Are we following? Okay. The next step is to configure administrator approval. So now we go to where we have the PXE response. The PXE. So we click on PXE response. Yeah, yeah. But it said it's specified. It's invalid. Okay. Let's
see the percentage before the number.
Oh, is it before the number? Oh, sorry. So we put that before the number. Okay, let's go to PXE settings. It's still invalid. Yeah, this thing is. Let me see. Could it remove the dollar sign 61? Let's see if that will work. Okay. Just remove the dollar sign, the percentage sign, and the 61. Just take it out. Yeah. Then go to PXC settings. Now you notice it says respond to all clients, known and unknown. Is that not what we selected before? Now it said we should select require administrator approval for what? Unknown computers. Because no computer systems, you already know them. It will automatically approve them. Now this one, we do not know them, so we're going to click on require. Are we together? And it says we should change the PXC seconds to delay to how many? 3. So we could just come there, drop, push it up to 3 seconds. Have we done that?
Yes.
Now, before we proceed, the next task, it says we should use the PowerShell to create a message. We're going to be creating a message. Now, that message is going to pop up and say the PCE administrator is authorizing this request. Please wait. Are we together? Huh? It's like a message. We're going to type that message. So, to do that, let's go to the PowerShell. While your property is still open, go to the PowerShell, right click on it, and run as administrator. Run as administrator. Then let's type WDSUTIL. WDSUTIL. PCE administrator is authorizing this request. Full stop. Please wait. Then you close the, you close it. Then press enter. Yeah, there's a full stop after the request. Let's see. Just a minute. Ah, put a space. No. Put a space in between. When you see, let me show you what I mean. Take your arrow key, use the arrow key, go to where you have, yeah, where you have the second forward slash, then space it, then go to where you have the forward slash before message, space it, then you press enter. Then that will work. Now, is that is done? Can we go back to the property? Can we close this? Can we go back to the property, please? Can I have one class? Can we go back to the property? Now, I want you to go to the boot. Now, there's one thing I've noticed with VirtualBox. With VirtualBox, if I was to require user to press F12, it doesn't really work. But I think with Hyper-V, it might work there in Hyper-V. So what I usually do, I select always continue to the PXC boot. Are we together? Because I'm using VirtualBox. In other virtual machine, F12 might work. But one thing I've noticed with VirtualBox, I usually just put always continue. Now this is on node clients. Are you getting me? Now we're not really working with node clients, so it's fine for the default. Now did you notice there, it said you should add a boot image. Did you see that there? Did you see? It says you should add a boot image. And this is where you can come and select a specific boot image for what? For the server, for it to boot up with. Okay. Now, what's the next step I wanted to show you? Okay, let's go to not advanced. Is it the clients? Yeah, click on the clients. Now, if I wanted to install this operating system with certain configurations, I've already set up with the DISM. When I've created an unattended installation file, remember the unattended .xml. If I've created a file such as like that, I will come here and say enable unattended installation. Then I will click on browse. Excuse me. If it's an x64 bit, or which is 32 bit or 64 bit, I will click browse, and I will select that answer file here by going to WDS unattended. Then I will look. I would have copied the file prior to this. I will paste the file there. Then I will select the file. That was what I did with Jimmy's laptop when I had to install the first image I gave to you guys, the Windows Essential. I had to take that Essential file, go to Windows 8, service the image by creating an unattended file. On the option where it says you should install with the activation key, I asked it to skip. Then I created an answer file, copied it into the server, placed it here, added the answer file, then deployed Windows Server 2012 Essential right through the server system. When the server got to the point where it has to ask for installation, that was answered automatically. I didn't even have to click anything. It just went through, got the server installed. Is that not correct? It got the server installed, and that was how I was able to skip the installation. You can actually do that with any operating system, especially from Vista all the way to Windows 8.1. It will work. Are we together? I'm just showing you that just in case. If that is done, all the next step we need to do is to click apply and what? You click apply and okay. I'll just give it a time. It will come up. Let me just pause it for. I've changed my settings. Is now I've clicked on the okay button, so my settings are now perfect. So let's go to the server manager. Sorry, the server manager. Go to tools, Active Directory. Users and computers. Now, on the research OU, can you go to the research OU? Right click on it, then you see delegation control. Click next. Now, according to the lab, we're asked to delegate server one the ability to create computer objects in the OU. So we click add, and we're looking for who now? We're looking for computer objects. So can you go to object types, then select computers, select computer. Then we type SVR1, check names, your server one will pop up. Take note, this is what I did. Let me go back. Research OU, right click, delegation control. When you click on next, if you click add user and groups, you notice it's only users and groups that are here. But our lab says we should delegate it to the computer. So what I did, I came to object types, then I selected computers because it's not done by default. So when I selected computer, I clicked on OK. Then I came in here and I typed server one, which is the name of my server. Then I clicked on check names. Automatically, the name is checked. I click OK. And I'll click on what? Next. Now we're asked that the delegation control that it should be able to create. Okay, we're asked to create computer objects. So the task is to create a custom task. So we'll come here and say custom task, which is the second option. We click next. Then which on the object, we're to select computer objects. Can we select computer objects? And you should be able to create objects in the selected what? Folder. So we create, you should be able to create object, not to delete, but to what? Create. So you want to be very careful not to give these two options, especially if you're doing that to a user. Okay, we click next. Then on the permission, we should give full control. So we give full control on the permission. Full control. We click next and we click on finish. That is it. We're done. So I'll stop here. Then the next task we'll do is to do what? Deploy. Is that not correct? That is exercise 4. We'll be deploying the image with Windows WDS. So I'll stop here now on exercise 3.